Hey, it's Kirk with Secret Nature. Welcome to your Radioactive House episode 3. This is the last of the background information before we go start measuring stuff around the house. I do, however, today have my Geiger counter with me because I want to talk about something that's really important to understanding the videos that are coming later on, and that is the idea of dose versus rate. And I like to explain it again with candy. This is the third episode where we're talking about candy. So if my son, who's 10, came to me right before dinner and said, "Hey, Dad, I want to have some candy before dinner," I might kind of say, "Well, what do you mean you want to have some candy?" And he said, might say to me, "I want to have one piece of candy per minute until dinner." Now, that'd be a really, really weird way for a 10-year-old to ask for candy, but let's just say that's what he says. One piece of candy per minute. Well, I would look at my watch and say, okay, dinner's ready in 5 minutes. That's five pieces of candy. That's the rate he is requesting. Now, it would kind of depend. If he's talking about M&Ms, one M&M per minute for 5 minutes is five M&Ms. That's not that big a deal. But what if he's talking about a candy bar? And he wants to eat one candy bar per minute for the next 5 minutes and have five of these before dinner. That's a really big difference. And it goes to the point of the difference between a rate and a dose. So when we're talking about radiation, a Geiger counter like this can measure two things. Now, this happens to be a Rad Alert 50. I'll do a video where I talk more about that later. But there's a couple settings on here. I'm gonna turn it on. You'll hear it start to click because it's going to start to measure the background radiation here in my house. And I have it set to something called counts per minute. This is essentially the rate. How many detections of radioactive decay is it picking up in a minute's time? Here in my house, it usually gets a rate of about 20 counts per minute. Now, there is another setting on here. If I slide this up, it's going to tell me millirems per hour. That's a dose rating of how much radiation I can get, and based on that you can figure out what is safe. But here's something we got to really think about, and if you ever go out and decide you want to buy one of these, something you should be aware of is that this is not that smart a device. It is only detecting when there's some sort of radiological decay that hits the sensor inside here. It can't really tell if it is alpha radiation, beta radiation, or gamma radiation. And so it also can't tell how high energy any of those things are. And that's important information to try to figure out if you have exceeded your safe dose of exposure to radiation. So how do they know what the dose is here when you put it on the dose setting? It's a mathematical model based on knowing what size candy bar or what size candy it's detecting. So they have to calibrate these to some sort of known source. In this case, it's usually cesium. This one is calibrated with cesium. Well, I don't have any cesium here in my house. There are other radioactive substances we're gonna look around and try to find, but there's not gonna be any cesium. So if I put it on this dose setting and I were to test uranium or radium or something like that, I'm not gonna get an accurate reading. That's something people need to understand when they're using these. You're only getting an accurate rating for the dose if it's measuring the actual isotope that it was calibrated to. So I'm not going to be using that setting for any of my videos because we're not going to be able to get an accurate reading for what the dosage is. I'm going to put it on counts per minute, and that's going to tell us generally how radioactively or active that substance is. If I put it on one thing and I'm getting a reading of 40, well, that's double background radiation. If I put it on something else and I get a reading of 30,000, it's like, whoa, hold on. That is a much more radiologically active sample than the other one. But I'm not gonna be able to get an exact dose idea based off of the number I'm getting on here. So that's an important thing to keep in mind. We can make some generalizations though. If we have something that has some uranium in it and we're getting a rate, not a dose. We're getting a rate of like 40 counts per minute. That's not really something we need to worry about. So we can get a general idea, but it's not gonna give us an actual dosage rating that you're gonna get. This is great. Right now I'm getting 11 on here. This is gonna go up and down throughout the day. Sometimes I'll get a background reading of about 20 in my house. Oh, I jumped up to 15. It's gonna vary back and forth, but we're gonna be looking for things that get our numbers higher than that here in the house. That's it. That was my explanation of dose versus rate. I hope it makes sense to you as we go forward. The next episodes are going to be looking at what things in my house and yours are radioactive. So I'll see you back soon as we explore and find some stuff around the house that is radioactive.
Thanks for watching. You can click the Secret Nature button in the middle there to subscribe to this channel and receive more content. You can also click on one of the playlists on the left or right for more from Secret Nature. Thanks for liking, commenting, and subscribing.